place on Christmas Eve, we are so glad that you are able to be with us on this special holy night. I'm Chris Light, the pastor here at Uni Place, and I want to give you a warm welcome on behalf of all of us. It is such a treat for us to be able to gather again this year after not being able to meet in this place last Christmas Eve. Now, churches are used to giving things up for Lent, but churches have had to give up a whole lot of stuff for the pandemic, and we're still doing that. So I appreciate so much you wearing your masks tonight. We do ask you to keep them on until you take communion and then put them back on for the safety of everyone as we continue to protect one another's health. You might have noticed as you came in that the way we do communion in the pandemic has been, we have individual portions in a little reusable metal tin that we sanitize every week, and it has a grape and a cracker in it. So you have your fruit of the vine and you have your bread of the world, and we're glad that you have that with you. If you don't have one, if you did not get one out of the basket coming in, if you raise a hand, I bet you Renee back there who's nodding her head would be happy to bring communion to anybody get a little silver box when they came in. You also should have gotten a candle, and we will end the service by spreading the light of Christ down the pews, and so somebody will appear at the end of the pew, light the first person's candle, and I'm going to give you a little demonstration of that. There's a reason for the demonstration, and it's called hot wax. All right, they're not off to a great start. I'll get that in a minute. When you are, thank you. It's nice to have your husband as littered as well. He's used to picking up after me. When you are lighting the candle, you've got the light and you're thinking, oh, let me light your candle. You are dropping hot wax. Don't do that. When you are lighting the candle, you hold up the unlit candle like this, and then the unlit candle is going to go to the flame so that the wax goes to the cute little skirt. Got it? All right, so let's all be safe. Another thing that we have given up during the pandemic, besides passing the communion trays, is passing the offering trays. And so you'll see that it's in the bulletin that we're taking an offering. Our offering tonight is going to disaster relief for those who have experienced the great storms that have affected our country in recent weeks. And they will join through our Disaster Relief Fund Week of Compassion, who is already on the ground working there in Mayfield and Tennessee and a lot of other places. So if you would like to contribute to that, the offering plate is actually up here. So when Sam is singing this wonderful song for the offering music, that's a great time to dig it out of your purse and get it ready, or get out your wallet from your back pocket, and then you can simply put it in the offering plate as you're leaving. And that's the last thing to tell you about how we're doing things. As you are leaving, we do ask that you extinguish your candle, and we'll have the baskets out at the doors so that you can put those back in as you leave. We will be turning the lights off as we get to the point where we're spreading the light through the sanctuary, but they will go back up for the safety of everyone as we're finally leaving. Thank you again for joining with us on this holy night. And now let us begin by passing the peace of Christ pandemic style, which is that I will say, the peace of Christ be with you, and you can look around at everybody, and this is sign language for, and also with you. Got it? The peace of Christ be with you.
And also with you.
And you, and you. Welcome to this time of worship.
As you are able, would you please stand and join me in our call to worship? The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light.
So great is coming of the light.
Oh, sing to the Lord a new song.
God's salvation is at hand.
Celebrate the coming of salvation.
For a child has been born for us, a son given to us.
Celebrate the coming of the Prince of Peace.
I bring you good news and great joy for all people.
Celebrate the coming of Christ. May be seated. Have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them has light shined. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar of their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, have broken as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the tramping warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace. for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. This is God's living word.
Just as the prophets foretold, light comes into the world. In a blaze of glory, angels and shepherds mingle in wonder as the birth of a baby changes the world. We come to celebrate with joy and wonder as we retell this wondrous story tonight. We celebrate the light which shines all around us. We sing praises to our merciful God. We kneel before the Christ child who makes God's promises come true. For on this special night, a child is born, and this changes everything. Shaw, Mary's Song. Blue homespun and the bend of my breast keep warm this small, hot, naked star. Fall into my arms. Rest, you who have had so far to come. Now nearness satisfies the body of God sweetly. Quiet he lies, whose vigor hurled a universe. He sleeps, whose eyelids have not closed before. His breath, so slight it seems no breath at all, once ruffled the dark deeps to sprout a world. Charmed by dove's voices, the whisper of straw, he dreams, hearing no music from his other spheres. Breath, mouth, ears, eyes, he is curtailed, who overflowed all skies, all years. Older than eternity, now he is new, now native to the earth as I am. Nailed to my poor planet, caught that I might be free, blind in my womb to know my darkness ended, brought to this birth for me to be newborn and for him to see me mended. I must see him torn. From the Gospel of Luke, chapter 2, verses 1 through 7. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be enrolled. This was the first registration that was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David, called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger because there was no place for them in the inn.
Said to them, "Do not be afraid. For see, I am bringing you good news of a great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. Then the angels proclaimed, "This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angels a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste, and they found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in a manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told to them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told to them.
I am that kind of mom. The kind of mom who reaches out and starts helping her kids before they have asked for help. Sometimes this works out well for everybody involved. But there have been enough troublesome times that have occurred because of this that my adult children all now say to me, "Mom, you just gotta stop trying to get your love all over us." I thought about that phrase as I was cleaning off the dining room table, getting ready for dinner tonight after the service is over. And there was a box there that had come from my sister Carol, who lives in the Pacific Northwest. And Carol also gets her love all over everybody. The way she gets her love all over us at Christmas time is she sends us a cardboard box, and she knows I have poor plastic, so everything is wrapped in newspaper. And there's little jars and little bags of things that she has made. So she sends us peppermint bark. It's made with carob. And she sends us the little clippings that we need to take account of. She sends us emails with all of the medical advice about why we shouldn't be enjoying any of the things we've been eating lately. But she gets her love all over us. And she knew that I would do what I was doing in that moment, which was smoothing out all of those crumpled newspapers so that I could fold them and recycle them more easily. And as I was doing that, I thought about the stuff that gets all over us. And I remember in one of the first scenes of the first episode of the first season of Downton Abbey, I learned something. I learned that back in the days of those big manor houses, there were always servants who had to get all the newspapers that came in and iron them before the Lord would read them, because otherwise those words would get all over him. And it occurred to me that we always listen to the prologue to John at this time of year, and we remember that in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. And John goes on to say, and the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. It seems to me God is that kind of parent who doesn't wait to be asked before getting divine love all over us. Knowing that we needed help, God came before we could ask. God came and drew near to us and gave to us. As we prepare now to come to the table, as we prepare to take that little bit of the fruit of the vine and the bread of life, let us remember that God came down to get God's love all over the world. And so may we take it in tonight as we remember the Word become flesh that has come among us.
In our invitation to the offering, come now and kneel before the Christ child. Bring all that you are and all that you have. Offer your gifts in wonder and surprise and awe. Offer your gifts in joy and delight. For Christ has come that we might all be brought into the light of his grace. Will the deacons please now accept our gifts of love and invite you to come forward?
You can come forward during the music, or you can drop off your offering on your way out of the offering plate. It's right up by the Christmas street.
Christian friends, rejoice with heart and soul and voice. Listen now to what we say. News, news, Jesus Christ is born today. Ox and ass before him bow, and he is in the manger now. Christ is born today. Christ is born today. Christian friends, rejoice with heart and soul and voice. Now you hear of endless bliss. Joy, joy, Jesus Christ was born for this. He has opened heaven's door, and we are blessed forevermore. Christ was born for this. Christ was born for this. Good Christian friends, rejoice with heart and soul and voice. Now you need not fear the grave. Peace, peace, Jesus Christ was born to save. Cause you one and cause you all to gain the everlasting horn. Christ was born to save. Christ was born to save.
We are thankful tonight for so many things. Receive these tokens of our gratitude for your love made flesh among us. May they become an expression of Emmanuel, God with us, for all the world. May they breathe back into the world a sense of wonder and joy. Amen.
On this night, we are enveloped in mystery. God with us, Emmanuel, has come to touch our world and to change our lives. God with us has come to bring us out of darkness and into God's own glorious light. God with us invites us to this table, believing in the promises of God, which are fulfilled tonight. In the stillness of the sanctuary, we hear the angels sing. We see the shepherds welcomed into the inner circle of God's trusted ones. We watch as the poor receive good news, which is just for them, and the powerful of the world are challenged by an infant king. Here love is offered. Here love is found in the sharing of the bread and cup. Here we find our journey's end and its beginning. All are welcome to share this feast of joy. Will you pray with us?
Good and gracious God, you have given us the gift of your Son, Jesus Christ. We come knowing and what's expected of this evening. And yet in that first evening, when the world welcomed your child, your Son, it changed the world and upset people's expectations of power and of love and of peace. We pray, dear God, that your peace continues to overcome all strife, that your love overcomes all division, that your hope overcomes all despair. And let us be participants through this bread and this cup, that we may remember a life given through Jesus Christ, a life given for the salvation of the world. And so we enter, simply giving you thanks. Amen.
On the very night he was betrayed, Jesus sat at the table together with his disciples. And during the supper, he took bread, blessed and broke it, and gave it to them, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body, which is given for you." Likewise, taking the cup after supper, he said, "Drink of this, all of you, for this cup is a new covenant in my blood for the forgiveness of sin. As often as you eat and drink, do this and remember me." As Samir plays Silent Night for us, you are invited to extinguish the candles as you go out, but certainly stay and linger as long as you would like as we're listening to the beautiful music that sends us on our way. We pray, O God, that Lord Jesus would come to us, that Jesus would be born this night in our hearts, our minds, our lives. May the light of your life be kindled in us and lead us to the shining truth of God with us, God for us, God in us. Amen.